And as the debate around constitutional recognition continues to heat up, two veteran authors have used their latest novels to raise awareness of the importance of recognising Aboriginal peoples as the rightful custodians of the land.
Respected writers Kate Howarth and Father Frank Brennan are challenging Australia's understanding of Indigenous peoples. Both have focused their novels around their experience of Aboriginal Australia and the ongoing struggles faced by the community. Father Brennan's latest book, No Small Change, The Road to Recognition for Indigenous Australia, looks at the push for constitutional reform and reminds readers of the tainted relationship between the government and Aboriginal peoples.
I think what it would do would be the assurance that in the post-colonial society that there is a constitutional recognition that we, the Indigenous people, belong here, that our cultures, traditions and relationship with lands and waters is absolutely central. In fact, it's constitutive of the nation. Then that provides a firmer basis for moving forward and putting behind us what, after all, is still the reality of our constitution. It's still basically a constitution which is marked by terra nullius and assimilation. Aboriginal people are not even mentioned. Well, we need the mention in there.
With recent reports revealing 87% of the Aboriginal community would vote yes to change the constitution, Father Brennan says it is still a process that must be treated delicately.
None of us would be so naive as to say, well, all Aboriginal leaders should agree. That never happens, whether you're Aboriginal or non-Aboriginal. But we can expect, I think, that there can be some convergence of majority viewpoint among respected Aboriginal leaders.
However, Settling Day author Kate Howarth says despite the 13% of people who are not ready to change the constitution, now is the time to amend the documents and officially recognise Aboriginal people as the original custodians of the land.
You know, most of this country, with very few exceptions, you know, unless you go into very remote parts of Australia or you go up into Yolngu country or you go out into the Kakadu, most of the urbanised parts of Australia, very, very multicultural, very mixed race people. And one would have thought it should be higher than 87%. That would say give our people, the First Nation people, recognition. I think it's insulting that we have to even ask for recognition.
Mikaela Simpson, NITV News.